safe is an investigative journalist in India today?
On Delhi roads, average 5 people get killed every day on road accidents. So I think being a journalist is safer than being a driver. So I don't think that we should dramatize the profession. We should be the flies on the wall. You know, we should just do the story, move on. Yes, the new government is far more authoritarian, and they have foot soldiers who shout you down if you attack them.
Do you think you can your investigation can be questioned on the basis of that?
There are occasions where you break the law fully well aware, or I won't say break the law, you bend the law, you adopt tactics that may fringe on being illegal for the larger good of the society, and that has been done through history, that will continue to be done. So that is one of the reasons why I do not condemn hidden cameras, though I don't do it myself, because it helps in at one level to unearth things that traditional investigative journalism cannot in a country so duplicitous like dubious like ours. So I don't have a moment of regret about using some unethical method, because using the unethical method, I am helping the society uncover something very large, and there is no other way out.
Doesn't your investigation get lost in social media?
Now it is surprising that people find very idiotic reasons to classify all of us into the bare identities of being Christian and
why
black and white.
Oh,
that is because it's part of an orchestrated political campaign which is getting some people power, and that's the easiest way to override your responsibility of being a responsible political party to bring welfare to the people. That's the politics of hatred that is getting them this thing, and a lot of journalists are falling prey to that politics of hatred. I don't look at Facebook opinions to decide whether I was right or wrong. I look at my conscience, and I look at the poorest Indian, and I look at them and think that, are you getting the welfare? If you are not getting welfare, who is holding it back, and how do I expose it?
What were the biggest challenges that you faced while putting something like this out there?
I have a certain theory about modern India, which is that everything is on sale in this country, whether it's a birth certificate or a government. You just need to get to the right middleman and pay the right bribes. So I wanted to prove that. Now, while proving that, I didn't want to be philosophical, I didn't want to be condescending, I wanted it to be stories that you and I will identify with. So finding the stories took me a lot of time. So I went around the country, traveling to deep interiors, traveling to cities, and then to substantiate those stories and those claims, I'd look for documents. So it has been a very long journey. I already received two defamation notices from two major corporations. So the challenge is just beginning. But that's okay. I mean, I'm ready for it.